Hey, what's up guys? Nuno here. I know that many Lumion users didn't upgrade to Lumion 12 yet, and with this, they don't have a dedicated slot to add a gloss map, for example. And as you may notice already, I'm always recommend you to add the gloss map into the alpha channel of the normal map. To do this, you need to go to Photoshop and repeat this procedure every time for every new texture. It can take some time. But if you're using Megascans textures, that is a better and faster way. A user here on YouTube by the name Gabriel Puffellini, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, he made this comment suggesting that we can use Quixel Bridge to set up custom export settings. We can set up automatically the roughness into the alpha channel of the albedo, or the gloss into the alpha channel of the normal map, or even invert the green from the normal map directly from Bridge. So, today's video, I'll show you how you can set up these Quixel Bridge custom exports to have all the maps ready for Lumion. So, let's get started. The first thing we need to do is go to Quixel website, and we'll find on the products, here on the top, you'll find Bridge, and I'm already here on this page, and you click here, download Bridge. And so you install this this software. Here we have Quixel Bridge. This is the main screen. And here you can see on the left side, we have 3D assets, surfaces. These surfaces are materials. We have decals, perfections, all of this. You can even sort this out by collections. And if you go, for example, to environment, and let's say natural, I can see different types of nature, like canyons of Utah, Iceland, pine essentials, ocean. So if I select this, if I had a project that is basically on a Nordic coast, I can select from these assets, and this is all high quality assets. But for this video, we'll use a surface, and I want the soil surface. So here, soil. Oh, as you can see, going back a little bit, everything is categorized. So we have concrete, we have asphalt, grass, a lot of different things. So let's go to soil. And let me see which one I want to try. So just to test, I want to see this one, soil tire tracks. And here, if you click, you can see the texture maps, different texture maps. You can see a preview, 3D preview. So how it looks. And if you notice here on the bottom, it says 2x7x2x7. And in Lumion, when you are defining the map scale, it's in meters. For this map to be the correct size, you need to set in Lumion 2.7 as well. And if you like this asset, you can just click here to favorite the asset. And now, before clicking download, let me show you here. When you click this bottom icon next to the resolution, we'll go to export settings. And on this export target, we're going to select custom disk export. They already have some presets for Max, Maya, Unity, Unreal Engine. But we're going to select custom disk. And then we set up here a folder. I already have set up here mine. And now we go to textures. And on the textures, you'll probably find here format as JPEG, but select Targa. And now on surfaces, which are the textures, we have albedo. So we're going to select albedo. And on the albedo, we're going to go here and select RGBA. So we have the alpha channel as well. And on the alpha channel, it's already here selected roughness, but you can select many different types of maps that you want, but for Lumion, we'll select roughness. Then we have displacement. Displacement, we're gonna leave it as it is, as gray. And normal map, you could as well select RGBA and add here the gloss map, okay? But we already add the roughness into the albedo, and the roughness and gloss, they are the same map. It's just inverted from one another. So either you use the roughness map on the albedo or the gloss map on the normal map. Don't use both together. On the normal map, another thing we are going to do is, if you see here the green channel, which is the G here, we're going to select normal Y, inverted. So for Lumion, the Megascans textures, they need to be with the green inverted. So we can select this option and it will export already with the correct settings. Okay, so you don't have to do anything else in Lumion. And we close this, and for Lumion there's nothing else we need, just this three maps, okay? I mean, four maps, because we are adding the roughness into the alpha channel of the albedo. And then, we can go here back. Before going back, let me just show you that for the models, what I do is select FBX, and I select the high poly source, which is the model that contains the most information, it's the most heavy, with a higher poly count. And I just use this one if the camera is really close to it, okay? Then I have load zero. Load zero is a high quality asset, and I'm using most of my assets with this load zero because they are not so heavy and they look nice. But if the asset is really far away, I use this load five because it's a version with a reduced number of polygons and it's much lighter for the scene. And you don't notice much difference between one and another. So sometimes you need to change these assets for a better performance on your scene, especially on large scenes. By the way, if you want to take your Lumion rendering skills to the next level, I invite you to join my Lumion Render course. It has more than 10 hours of step-by-step video tutorials. I will leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. And now we go back and we click download. So it will start to download the asset. And if we want to check the files that it downloaded, we go here to the three dots and go to files. But these are not the files that we need. These are just the textures of these maps. We don't need these files. We need to go here and click export because we set a custom export. And when we do this, we go to the folder that we previously set up. This one, let me show you again. This folder here. So the export location, we go to this folder. And so in my case, it's this one. As you can see, I have just a preview file and I have three target files, the albedo, the displacement and the normal. And if I open here the displacement on Photoshop and now I go to channels and alpha, you can see that it already has the roughness into the alpha channel. So as I said, now we don't need to do all of these settings again here inside this Photoshop. Before we continue to Lumion, there is one thing that I noticed. I downloaded the 8K and 4K of the same version, and one without the green inverted here on the Quixel application, and the other with the green inverted. And what I noticed is that both are exactly the same. So in reality, the normal map is not being inverted in this Quixel bridge application. And I even found a support on their forum with exactly the same thing. Someone comparing both the normals inverted and without being inverted, and they are exactly the same. And this thread is already 1 year old and with no answers. So I'm guessing this is a bug that wasn't fixed yet. So what I suggest to do is, when you go to load your material into Lumion, so I have your Lumion 11.5. So I have here these maps. So I have the albedo, which has the roughness on the alpha channel. And this one is 2 meters. So let's put here 2 meters. Yeah, that's enough. And then this normal map, I'm gonna load the normal map. But since it didn't invert the green, we will need to click here next to the relief, which is a normal map. There's this button, flip normal. So you just need to click this one button and that's it. The normals are inverted. Then I'm just going to choose the displacement. Increase, you can see here the difference that the displacement makes. So it's a little bit about here. And reflectivity, I'm going to decrease a little bit till here. And now I'm going to take a render of this and let's see how it looks. Oh, just one more thing before I hit render that I forgot to tell you. Is that you have to check if you have these extra options. If you don't, if it just shows like this, show more, click here, show more, and then go to the fourth icon, which is settings. And since we added the roughness into albedo, we need to say that the alpha channel is not the alpha clips object, but the alpha mask's reflectivity. Now it's correct, or else this map will make some transparency on the map. on the texture, I mean. So now let's try to render. And this is the final result. So as you can see, it was quite simple to set up all of these exports in Quixel Bridge. It's just to pay attention about that normal, that probably it's a bug, so you cannot really invert a normal in Quixel Bridge. But it's really fast to do it in Lumion, just press this one button and that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video, let me know what you think about it, and don't forget to give it a like. And I would like to remind you that you can sign up for my free training, my top 10 tips to achieve realistic renders. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. And I'll see you in the next one.